Hello, folks. It's Rever here again. Back for another episode of Silage Farm on the Gifts of the Caucasus. It's mostly been silage, but we actually got to do some real crop harvesting. And we are down there unloading some silage. So we're getting some money back in right now. And from the last episode, I had started this harvest and pretty much just got done. There's the last of my sugar beets. If you take a look at the quantities there, I imagine most of you can read them. The question marks are on the camera. My goal, I don't forget whether I had said it or not, was more or less to get 100,000 of each different thing. And I'm getting awful close, as you can see. I certainly have enough sugar beets now. I have some, starting from the bottom there, the second one up is oats. And I have a field full of oats planted. And going up a little bit, the sunflowers that I just harvested, which was what, well, not a third of the field, probably a little better than a third of the field, only got me 37,000. And then going up corn, I only have 47,000 of that. Canola is planted in field 19, which is actually ready to harvest now. And we'll start that in a minute here. This guy could probably get parked. Just the trailer can get parked. The tractor's kind of in the way, isn't it? Let's hop over to him real quick and get him out of the way altogether. Over here might be good. Done with this trailer for a little while. So what I would like to do, at least to start the episode, is drop that. Need him. As a matter of fact, while we're here, what I decided to do was to plant some more sunflowers, which I believe I have to do with this one. There we go. Over here. Let's fill up with some fuel while we're going. So I would like to try to see how I make out just course playing field 19. The chaser course that I had before was done with the tractor that could only travel at 32 miles per hour. So what I want to do is chase, now that I got that other, the tractor and trailer combination, what do we got here? Wheat at the railroad station. Okay. So, what do we got? I will accept the mission. And let's just drop this guy where he is. I'm going to use this trailer. I think it's worth the time to clean him rather than bringing that other guy back. I hope this works. Alright, so we got 8 minutes to get to the railroad station, which isn't far. Should be plenty of time. Just dropped off that trailer, which is probably dirty. 17,000, yep, that'll be a good trailer for it. There's no weight on front to clean. Yeah, I should have hooked up that trailer first. I guess I can. It doesn't matter whether I put wheat in it first or not. That trailer doesn't look very dirty at all. Let's pull him out and take a look. Yeah, we're going to clean it. We're just not going to take the chance. 7 minutes should be enough time to get down there. It's only, let's see it from here, so. Shouldn't be a long trip. Not sure why that, it's kind of glitching. I'm not pressing the button. It's just, as soon as I turned it on, I've got the blonde on. should be plenty clean. Let's see if I can't swing around through this way. Why not? Turn on F1 so I can tell the instant that I get symbol. Make sure I'm in the right place. There we go. R. Let's give me wheat. Let's just sell them 37,000. Why not? Right? We got plenty of it. I don't know during these cargo deliveries if we get a higher price, but whatever. I know we get a, you know, we get, I assume we get money for selling the wheat, and I know we get a bonus for the cargo itself. Very good. Yeah, the extra time to wash this guy. Well, the blue number two, T6 there, it wasn't clean either. Tractor trailer is clean. It's down there getting ready for field 19. That's cool. Makes for better YouTube. Something exciting happens. We got 5 minutes left. Really good shape. However, I've never sold anything to the railroad station. I know it's a pretty big place. I don't think it's going to take more than a minute. Down there, 2 minutes at the very most, so that would leave me a good 3 minutes to figure out where we got to drop this stuff off. Not that big a place. Careful. As long as the train doesn't come at this moment, I think we'll be in good shape. By the way, chasing with that tractor trailer is just 10 times better. Let's look for something that looks like... Let's see if we drive by these question marks come up. Beer, cake, seeds. This is wood, which we're going to work on sometime soon. I was in here before. Anything over there? Flower, that's us. All right, getting credit. Very good. Yeah, see, my money. Oh, it is going up. Okay. Yeah, my money really didn't go up during that. I was wondering. All right, well, we completed a mission. Wonderful. Very, very good. I guess I can slow down. I'm still in rush. Let's get this guy back up to the farm. Take a look at what that did for our status. Yeah, well, that's the whole point in getting over 100,000 or anything, is I can get, you know, make sure I always have something to complete those missions. Talk to you about the strategy. So, in other words, my strategy at this point is in this field, the field next to me, the three fields, I want to, you know, keep up my, well, I want to plant corn and I want to plant sugar beets or sunflowers, get them over 100,000. So I just want to plant the one crop this time, means I need a new outline, which we'll do shortly. We'll do that after we course play chaser course. Let's put this guy back for a moment. Leave him ready to go. He should be clean enough by some weird chance we got one mission. Let's just take a look at this. So we got 1 point for that, which is fine. So we're up to 37. I think 40, I know, allows us to buy some things. Still don't really have enough money to buy anything significant, but that's sort of one of my next goals. Let's close that. And what I want to do, I actually go to this guy. And this is canola. So we're down here in Field 19, canola. I was looking just to see, make sure I didn't want my windrow. So, windrow is a good source of chaff. We'll just come here. I know he's going to mess up this corner anyhow, so as well. Do a little bit of it myself. One of the reasons this is because I want this guy to end on the field after I do my chase, of course. Alright, so now let's jump over to this guy. So yeah, any chaser course I might have wouldn't go 40 miles an hour. It would be set to the speed of the tractor at the time, which, you know, this guy is just more responsive, quicker in general. So, I'll get rid of whatever course was loaded there. And I don't think it matters which one of those you select, but for now we'll do start course recording. We'll run him down to the, or up to the farm, whichever way you look at that. Side road. Just in case we get busyness happening down the road. At this point, we don't have too much, but one of the other things I wanted to talk to you guys about is I think I want to try to keep the grain mill. I want to try to keep the grain mill filled with stuff. You know, keep the stuff sold. See how much it takes to actually just grow those three crops. So it's slowed down greatly. So there's no problem getting through that stupid gate. Show you what I mean when I get the course recording. There's what, wheat, barley, and something else. So I'll just run right through here. Hopefully he'll make this turn without a problem. Kind of keep it tight. Keep things gentle. This way. Try to stay crossing this course too much. Could have gone in a different gate. So, see, this guy's getting up. He gets up to speed a little bit better than that other tractor. Shouldn't be a big problem with him. Through here. They really are better off, especially in these kind of turns. You know, that's good enough right there. Another thing I wanted to point out, there's something wrong with this map. It actually dead stops my chrome. See how this trailer bounces around right there? Funny. There's something going on. I haven't really looked into it. Must have been there, got deleted, or the road, you know, just takes too much of an angle. Kind of goes up and down, flat. Alright, so we're gonna come here. Like I said, you kind of want to stop this guy on the field. I think it makes it easier. Alright, so this is gonna be
F-19 chase to main farm silo. Save. Now, we're going to have to get this guy out of the way for a little while. At least until the guy goes by. But, I want to come here. Axle flow case. I don't think I'm missing anything else. Yep, we'll be ready when we come back. Let's get this thing popped up for some reason. This guy's off the field enough. And we'll come back to here. And we will tell this guy to drive course at the first waypoint. Kind of drives past that first waypoint anyway, which means he missed something. Takes this turn too wide, misses something. But we should be in pretty good shape. Go back to this guy. Let's just tell him. Oh, levels. Let's make sure the levels make sense. This guy holds about 10,000. Which means I think I will try 85%. Like, I want them to be mostly full, but I don't want them sitting there waiting for some tiny percentage and then taking too long to get back. Let's do 60. Just see how that goes. It should be close enough. Alright. No combine in reach. See, that's kind of, by the way, okay, waiting till fill level. There we go. So that should be set up. We'll check back on it in a minute after we figure out what the heck we were doing. Yep, there's my new Deutz Fahr we bought in the last episode. There's him. Yep, he's ready for another delivery. I kind of doubt we'll get one back to back, but who knows. This guy's going. This guy's sitting over by the land thing where we left him last time we bought something. This guy's selling stuff. EGA. I do want to get the silage going at some point here. Not silage, but a slurry going. Let's see how much we got. 380,000 basically, which is going to be a good amount. We got these two going. Let's run. 32%. 42%, yeah, so I really don't think I'm going to... If purchasing that field comes back, I really doubt I'm going to have the money. You know, I'd have probably, what, 1,900 or 190,000, I mean. As far as, you know, even if that whole silo got sold. It'll be a good chunk. The good news is by the end of tonight, I think those might be ready. Maybe we'll be able to pay some of it back. Not have to borrow quite so much money. Alright, so now everything's kind of settled down. Let's get rid of that. Get rid of this. This. So what I would like to do... Let me get my course play on. I'm going to go down and just shrink this down. I don't need it. Don't need it very wide. That's what I'm about to do. I'm going to make sure that green line is overhanging. Right here. We're going to create an outline of the entire thing. The entire field, which we didn't do last time. Take our time, do it well. Because I think most of the time, you know, we're just going to plant this full field. A little bit wider here. It sort of gets a little bit wider. I'm going to try to stay outside of the field itself. After my last experience, if you guys remember from the last episode, it didn't quite... Turn up the cruise control a little bit, huh? Anyway, when I when I went to harvest it, it didn't harvest the whole thing. It kind of left the row, so I figure I'm better off just overlapping. The planter won't plant on the grass, but the harvester will overlap enough to not cause issues. And then I think we will plant some more sunflowers probably to start out. I'm going to go so far as to 90 degree turn this. Move it down a little bit. Why not? Doesn't, like I said, it really doesn't matter how long, how you set this course up, as long as it goes all the way around. Comes reasonably close to meeting at the other end. Degrees again. This should be okay. And we'll even go around this little jutty part here. But yeah, the harvest went reasonably well. A little bit of stuff to clean up on either end. All in all, I'm happy with the way it went. This little jutty part's annoying. It'll be crops. Worked out pretty well. Nine degrees. That's just a beautiful thing. Beginning here. And that should be fine. Stop, save, F10, 11, 12, outline. And just because I have other ones, I'll put all. And we'll see. So let's go check on. That screen just pops open whether I want it or not. Let's just real quick see how this guy's doing. Yeah, he did something. And all was nice because you don't get so, I mean, it's good and bad. You don't get so much of it. But he seems to have successfully chased and not crashed into anything that time. That's the hardest. Yeah, he hasn't even made a row yet. Well, we'll see. They're doing their thing. Didn't get red warnings yet. Go back to this guy. Kind of done with him. Turn off his park him out of the way somewhere. $608,000. Well, that was 400. Guys, we're gonna go right back into as much debt. Okay. That's okay. I hope I didn't mess myself up. Let's come back here. Jump out. And make sure. I hope that didn't just mess me up. Yeah, it probably did. Because usually it says offer or something. Let's just see. Who knows? Maybe we'll. I can always pay the money right back. There, let's go over here. Borrow until we have 610,000. That train is awful loud. So I can always just pay it right back if this doesn't work. Nobody's offered to sell me a field. Well, no, maybe that's not true. All right, let's come back here and yep. Darn it. All right, well, we'll just sit there. We won't return the money until after dark, kind of thing, if we have to. I don't really plan on buying anything else except for that. Well, I plan on buying a lot of things, but not today. Other than things I need to plant trees. Okay, so in any event, what were we doing? I have no idea. Let's get off of this. I want to go here. Drop that off. Oh no, I'm not. Oh, the cedar. That's right. I was going to see. I really don't need this big guy to see. I don't need this tractor out. Got kind of a mess going here, if you haven't noticed. Let's get this guy out of the way. Since I'm going to plant sunflowers, I think I'm just going to leave this header right on here. This tractor does, you know, it's not the greatest, but I don't know if I can get another header to do the sunflowers. We can experiment later. Alright, so there we go. So let's use this guy to plant these seeds. This is where we were. Alright, now we'll give him some gas. Now the brain is clicking. Some fuel. Tight. Oh, this is empty. Wonder why I couldn't change the tight. Yeah, I mean, this is annoying in some ways, but it's, I like the realism of, I always thought it was a bit hokey that you could fill up like that. You're just switching in the middle of the field, the types. You should have to go back to some kind of a station or wagon or something to refill. I guess we'll start up in this end. And our chasing, just looking at my numbers on my glance mod, chasing seems to be going pretty well. I don't see anything in the harvester, but it says harvesting and he is moving. He must be turning the corner. Yep, there he goes. He's getting some. So do we do this manual? Yeah, I think so. It's not like I have that much else going on. You know, I can stop this at any point. And let's see, just hit automatic. We're getting closer. Let's turn it 90 degrees. Don't want any offset. 5.8. This guy's actually 6. Yeah, we'll stick with 6. This is a pretty flat field. We should be okay. There we go. So now I'm planting some more sunflowers. And that'll get this crop up. And then I think after that round, I'll probably end up doing corn in here. There you go, that's the excitement for a little while. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything too dramatic happening in the next few minutes. A little bit more. Be all right.
get around here, I can move this guy back out. Yeah, I'm bad about that. People talk about making this super realistic. Well, it's not. I have worked on a farm and driven tractors, and just the fact you can't shift gears, I know a lot of tractors nowadays are getting automatic transmissions and things like that, but they don't all have automatic transmissions. As a matter of fact, most of them, especially the older ones, I don't think that was even an option. So you really, there should be something in the game to, make you have to, you actually really just pick a gear and that's what you go in. So we had some tractors, probably not that many tractors, but one of the tractors on the farm was, it could go pretty fast, but it was tough to get started, because you had to start in that, super high gear. So that's what, I'm not sure that that's all that limited, tractors to a certain speed, but if you wanted the tractor to go 15 miles an hour, you had to kind of start out in that low gear, letting the clutch out real slow, getting there going. Started out with a real high RPM. We had a neighboring farm we would run stuff over to. If you had a trailer on it, it was even worse. Could try to shift it when you were moving, but that didn't work for me very well. I'm not the best guy at sinking gears or anything. Never saw the point that hard to put the clutch pedal in. So I guess I've never an off-road trucker. 9 times out of 10, if you were doing anything on the farm anyhow, one gear was fine. Grass, you kind of had your optimal speed for grass cutting or whatever the case was. Let's just take a quick look at this. Keep looking. Should be putting it back on growth. Look at that. So we are a busy little farm this hour. See, we got a little bit of crops there, but we can get right on the silage as soon as we get a tractor freed up. Which, do we have such a thing? I probably could. That Agroliner's so nice to chase with. I may just wait until he's done. In the meantime, I'll do this field, and then things will slow down a bit once this is replanted and sprayed. I'll get over and do more silage work. Certainly, it's like a full-time job. I'll leave you guys here for a second. For me, for like I've only said hours probably. But get this sunflower planted, get it sprayed with herbicide. Not herbicide, fertilizer. And then I will come back, like I've said before, when something slightly exciting happens, probably the purchase of that field. I'm not sure how long this episode's been. I know the segment of it is as long as any. And we'll see about getting some trees planted. We'll probably be the next new and exciting thing. And then other than that, we'll talk about selling stuff to the grain mill up there. Just want to get an idea how much it uses every day. How much crops I would need to, stay ahead of it. Like, it sort of determines, I'm going to assume to some extent that it's similar as, once I figure out how to work the grain. Let's take a look over here. Shops, factories, choose from this grain. Oh, there we go. Rye, corn, and wheat. So how much rye, corn, and wheat, will we need to grow to stay ahead of this grain mill? He only accepts 100,000 a day, so or he has 100,000 storage maximum, I should say. But how much does he really need a day? I can see he really wants some wheat there for some reason. But where, I don't know where he gets the corn and rye from. Does he need all three? And I think that, you know, knowing that should give me some rough idea, you know, as to what the other ones would do. So then where do we sell these things? You know, kind of get set up to do that. This, I really, at this point, plan on making, oh, look, there you go, regular maintenance per day, productivity, liters per hour, 9,000. Not quite sure what that means. But we can figure that out, you know, just to get an introduction to really the uniqueness of this map, which is the economy and buying these factories. I think we're pretty much on the cusp of that. Obviously, I'm still doing sunflowers. I've got a couple crops I want to get over 100,000. But knowing part of my decision, just so you guys know, is I got three big fields. So if nothing else, what if I just keep planting wheat, corn, and rye? You know, I'll probably plant the corn in this field, wheat and rye in the other ones, because they're just closer to the BGA when I get the windrow. See how this economy is working. And then we'll hopefully be able to buy that grain mill one of these years. Maybe 300 million, so that's why I'm just going to keep plugging away at my silage operation. And, yeah, so that's sort of my plan. And then, likewise with the trees, I think I'm going to bite the bullet and, you know, buy a field, which again, it's, if the cutting the wood thing doesn't work out that well, it's fine. I'll have field 18 to plant stuff in. And look at the map here, if I, and it's hard to see a lot of stuff going on, but there's field 17. If I could always plow these two together and make a real nice big size field. Looks like it might be worth doing that anyway, just because 17 is kind of a funny shape. But yeah, so 600,000 is quite a bit. So maybe this, maybe I saved myself, you know, if I come back with another offer, hopefully it's 500 and some thousand. I'm not sure how that works. Is it a random chance of a multiplier, or is it calculated somehow? Or maybe a little bit of both. Okay. There you go. I'm going to plant this field. We'll be back sometime in the not too distant future to do something else. See you guys in a minute. Hello, guys. Thought this was a good time to bring you back. I have turned plant growth off, but came in here and saw that they would sell the property this time for only $516,000. So it seems like it's fairly random how much they will increase it, because last time was 600 and some. So let me see about clicking OK. Yep, there goes the money. All right, let's just see what we did here real quick. So I just need to use a tractor. So we now own field number 18. What I am going to do is come back, you know, in a few minutes after I get done this. So you can see I was just in the process of seeding this field, and it's taken quite a while with this. I do want to get a better, oh, by the way, yeah, I changed my mind and went and cultivated this whole thing, and now I am planting some corn, just about out of seeds. So see, I pretty much have more than half of it done. A little bit of sugar, I guess. So, anyway, give me a few minutes and we'll come back and we'll take a look at field number 18. Hello, guys. I am back and I've gathered up some equipment. I also wanted to check to see what time the garden shop is open to. I'll come over here and hover over the garden center. So 6 to 20.
which is 2 hours away, so we got plenty of time to get there. Not too long ago, I downloaded a mod that would automatically load pallets, the flatbed trailer, and it would do these saplings, since I knew we were gonna start working on planting trees someplace. So like I said, I don't think I'm gonna get a penalty if I plant these on ground that I own. So let's go in here and purchase a bunch of stuff. And then I'm actually gonna call it an episode, because I don't want to get into the whole planning thing with only a few minutes left. This should take a few minutes to do this. So, it's here under these bale transport vehicles. And if you look, it's a pretty cool mod. You get different types of trucks. Man, Iveco, Scanion. And different trails. You got these dolly trailers. We call it tandem trailers. So you can hook them to whatever you want. So we're going to go see if it works. Let's try the steel one. It's the same price. I'd rather have a steel deck most of the time. Alright, so we bought that. Now, let's go back out here. Let's see, do we have anything? Nah, this is my one. Oh yeah, well, maybe it is. No. Misc. A lot of things go to Misc. Yes, there it is. Tree Planter Connect. So we are going to buy this. We'll go back. We're going to go over to regular forestry equipment. And we are going to buy 3 of these. Might be able to see where this is going. Uh-oh. I've had a bit of an issue. Alright, well, let's see. This guy, let's get attached to him. I would have planned around this a little bit. Alright, well, that thing. Okay, well, that was probably not the worst case scenario. Alright, now let's get in a tractor. Not sure if this guy can lift one of these, but he could certainly pull one out of the way or something. Yeah, he's doing fine. Alright, now let's get in this guy. So I was semi-prepared. I didn't expect the little, I don't know if I can load this when it's... Not really sure what to do about this. Somehow I gotta get that guy picked up. He doesn't really want to flip up on his own, does he? He should be folded. No idea how I would attach to him. I guess I could try the front. That's not going to work any better. Do I have to get like a front end loader to flip him up? So even if I just transfer him to... Maybe I'll try it from the other side. It's a bit of a bummer. Hmm. Well, I'm not sure what to say. All right, well, let's get this guy going. And then I'll cut the video once we... once I figure this out. Well, no, you know what? I'm going to cut the video. I'm going to figure out, like I said, I don't just want to transfer it to the upper farm because that's not any better necessarily. So I'll see if I can figure out a way to flip him up. Might have to go get the front end loader. All right, I'll see you in a minute. Okay, guys, here's the plan. I went and got the tractor trailer out of the way, and I went and got the front end loader for the T6. So I got the T8 backed up against them. I'm going to see if I can't lift them on there. Let's come over here, jump in, see, now that was not, that's, I mean the theory might be there, but, let's just try to go. Not push it, just see if I can't get under it. Can I lift? No. What if I. Well, that hit it. Yes, it's. Let's drag it back here a minute. I wonder if I pin it against the fence. Can I get under it? Plus, maybe I can get under it this way with the... At least get it up in the air. Not sure how much that's going to help. Well... Can't even push the damn thing. Oh, there you go. Yeah, this is... That's not what I would want. I can't flip it in the air. Yeah, see, it's just not where I would want it to be. Oh, look, I can lift it. Oh. I need to get away from the fence a little bit. I hope it doesn't fall. Yeah, so I can lift it. I just was at a really... Alright, let's lift this guy up a little bit. Just at the worst angle I could have picked. Alright, so let's see if I can't get... Man, I don't seem to be able to get under it. It's stuck on a fence. Well, it's got good collision physics, in a sense. Yeah, kind of. Alright, well, come with me. Not sure how I lifted you the first time now. No, what's going on? Jesus. I mean, you saw me lift it. If I just wasn't at that goofy angle. Yeah, let's get down closer where I can see. Can't make the episode last that long just for this. Maybe it'll come in flatter. Might be falling off because it's not flat enough. Yeah, there's only so long I'm willing to make the episode to try to get this thing lifted. You know what it actually looks like? Like this side is up a little bit. Yeah. Oh, come on. Now you're not going to collide right there? Come on, buddy. All right, I'm just going to try to lift it. Oh, please don't fall off. Can't see. Yeah, it looks like I need to be on this side. All right, there we go. Success. I had just had to get a little mad at it. You know, sometimes that helps in life when you... slight bit of cussing. I was on YouTube, so I wasn't cussing as much as I might in private. All right, well, since that ate some time, I'm sure this episode's long enough now. I will say goodbye, and I will be back in seconds in my time. Just pause the video long enough to reset, so to speak, and then I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a good day. Take care. Bye-bye.